you can incorporate a subsidiary of your parent company abroad in India. So if you want to establish a business in India and want to establish a wholly owned subsidiary of your foreign entity or a foreign company in India, then how to move ahead? So today we have with us Mr. Rachit. So he will tell us the basic points, like if a person of Indian origin or an NRI, non-resident Indian, or a foreign person wants to set up an entity in India and wants to do business in India, how can he do it through wholly owned subsidiary? So Mr. Rachit, please raise your points.
So first of all, today I will tell you what is a wholly owned subsidiary. Basically, wholly owned subsidiary is a company in which its parent company invest 100% in its shares. So basically, a wholly owned subsidiary is a company in which 100% shares are held by its parent company. In India, the wholly owned subsidiary will run by Indian law, that is Companies Act 2013. Basically, you have to register your private limited company in India. Under Ministry of Corporate Affairs, you have to file application for incorporation of a wholly owned subsidiary company. There is a whole process which is mentioned in Companies Act 2013.
So these are the points which you want to say.
Yes.
Okay. So tell me basic points, like how can we move, what is the process of moving, like what are the steps involved in, because there are foreign directors who are looking to set up their businesses in India and want to set up their entities in India through a wholly owned subsidiary. So what are the points which basically you want to focus on?
The most important, the first and foremost point is, as per section 149 subsection 4 of Companies Act 2013, you must have one resident director in India who will manage the whole operations in India. All the foreign directors cannot become the
main directors,
the main directors of company in India.
Like you want to say that without an Indian director, you cannot run any kind of business activity here in India.
There must be one Indian director. It's mandatory as per section 149 subsection 4. Also, the application will be filed by the resident director in India. There is no concept of electronic memorandum of association and article of association. You have to attach the physical forms in INC 32 form for incorporating your wholly owned subsidiary company. Also, the foreign directors, documents of foreign directors must be notarized and apostilled by their parent.
Can you tell me, like suppose if Mr. Roche is going to establish a wholly owned subsidiary in India with Mr. Rachit, suppose you are a director also in Indian company as an Indian capacity, as an Indian director. So how can Mr. Roche, and what are the documents required by Mr. Roche to be a director in India as a wholly owned subsidiary owner of that company?
Mr. Roche has to submit its local documents which are authorized by his country. That is apostilled by the embassy.
Local document means his origin country's documents.
Original country's documents. Suppose he is a resident of America, then the documents must be apostilled by the US embassy, which is present in India. His documents must be apostilled and certified by the US embassy. Then only he can submit those documents to Ministry of Corporate Affairs. After the submission of documents, he will be allotted a director identification number by Ministry of Corporate Affairs.
So here is the important points comes into the focus. Like, you have to take an Indian director identification number, without which you cannot be a director in a wholly owned subsidiary company in India here as a abroad director.
Right.
Okay. Apart from this, any other point you want to mention, like DSC or something like that?
For digital signatures also, you have to make a class 2 digital signature certificate. Also for that, you have to submit those apostille documents which will be certified by the embassy. You have to do a video verification, a simple 20 seconds video verification, in which you have to tell your name, address, and from which country you belong. Video verification as well as mobile verification you have to do with the local number, that will be your local guardian's number. Or you can do one thing, that you can take a new connection if you have the documents
of Indian connection, yeah, Indian mobile connection you need to take out, through which you can also do it.
I want to mention one thing. Also, in some cases, some digital signature authorities have exempted the mobile verification for the foreign directors, you can only do mobile verification also in some cases.
Okay, so that's a very beneficial part on the ministry side, which is making the rights and rules simpler for the foreign directors. So if you want to establish a company in India, then wholly owned subsidiary is the basic way. What are the benefits of wholly owned subsidiary in India and for foreign directors?
Basically, foreign directors have many chances to elaborate and diversify their businesses. India is a commercial hub nowadays. The labor is cheap here, land is cheap, so many countries are looking for investing in our country in India.
Even many countries have set up the export hubs from India.
Yeah, nowadays from China to India they are moving very fast, as because in India the land and the human resources are very cheap.
So the business ways are quite realistic and quite reasonable.
Also I want to mention one thing, the laws have become very very linear as compared to earlier. There are many benefits, exemptions.
Liberal laws are there right now.
In income tax also there are many benefits for the foreign investors. You can easily invest in India and also take back the money through automatic route, or there are many routes as prescribed in FEMA, that is Foreign Exchange Management Act. Yeah. Also RBI has liberalized the process to invest in India, and there are many ways you can issue your shares and allot your shares and also get your company listed if you are doing very well in India, as other companies are doing, you can also do.
What are the points which a foreign director needs to focus on if he wants to have a control in an Indian wholly owned subsidiary of his own, and he do not want that Indian director or resident Indian director take control of that company?
Basically, there are no such restrictions. You can control your wholly owned subsidiary fully, as the major shares are held by your parent company, which is in foreign. The resident director is just like a local guardian. He will be he's a just local guardian, and he will take his local affairs, regular affairs, to manage local affairs only.
He will just take care of regular day-to-day activities
business, like liaising with many departments.
So the control is always with the help with the hands of the foreign director,
the parent company basically.
So basically the parent company is being controlled by them. So
indirectly the company is controlled by
the foreign directors.
Yeah.
Okay. So in case there is no process of conflicts or chaos over here, so you can control your company by having a wholly owned subsidiary set up in India. So it's a very easy, very delicate kind of a thing. So if you want to go ahead with a foreign subsidiary incorporation, you can done with the help of a professional. And my number is also mentioned over here. So if you have any query related to the same, you can get in touch with me, or you have any kind of other query related to the same, you can just drop a WhatsApp to me on the given number given over here into the message box over there. So apart from this, any point you want to raise?
No, I think I have cleared all the points, major points. Rest, anybody can email us. You can reach
out. You can reach out on the description of the video. There is an email ID given over here.
To help
you can propose your entire proposal, like you want to set up your company and you have any query, you can get in touch with us through that description email ID. So thanks for watching the complete video, and if you like the video, please do hit the like button. And also, if you are new to our channel, you can also subscribe and hit that subscribe plus bell button. And thanks for watching, and do start your business in India and start the business throughout the India. So do take care of yours, and have a nice day ahead, and thank you so much. Remain connected and start your business through wholly owned subsidiary in India. Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye.